Hi, I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show. And first up this week, Craig, is...
Redemption. By Chris Ballinger.
Go.
And the biggest, hottest topic in magic at the moment is, what's better, Redemption by Chris Ballinger or Tool by David Stone?
Tool. Okay, that's the end of that then. No.
Come on. Dave's just a little bit jaded because we sat and we watched this DVD, and if you saw the interview that we did with Chris a couple of weeks ago, we told him to his face, this DVD goes on and on and on and on and on. And just when you think it's going to stop, it carries on going on. And it's like he's put together a million handlings. And I cannot believe, I know he said he had, I can't believe that Chris has worked every single one of those handlings. Because frankly, some of them are pretty cack.
Yeah, some of them aren't that good. He doesn't look like he's worked them a lot. But there are lots of ideas. At least you can work the ideas.
Some of them are really good. Like the
what's the best trick? What's the trick? What's the deal? You know, the best trick on the DVD.
Well, I'll tell you what the best trick. I'll tell you what. The original Redemption idea isn't as a torn and restored. It kind of is, but it's more as a finale to the Ambushers card. So his
they always say,
vision,
don't they, the best tricks can be described in one sentence.
Yeah, well... this one can't. But, you know, it's, the idea behind it is it's a finale for the Ambushers card. So you have a card signed, it's ripped into four, put in the spectator's hand, he takes the deck, taps the deck to the card, it vanishes, and then turns over the top card and it's the signed card.
He gets fantastic reactions for that.
He does.
Well. And like, it's like that young like kid on the street and he just taps it on his hand and the kid's like, where? Yeah, you know, is it really that good?
Well, I think that you shouldn't really combine the two. You've
Am got I getting jaded as a magician? You know,
don't start bringing up anything to do with jade right now. Okay. We're not going to go there. But, you know, I think that you've got the Ambushers card, you've got the Torn and Restored card, and I don't think the two mix. What I thought was very good is the Flash
Restoration.
I don't
think they believe for a second that when you go like that, that card's now vanished and that's the same card.
No, it's two effects. Somehow some pieces have vanished and the card was on the top of
that
from the beginning.
I think that's the perfect imperfect theory just gone... way out of control.
But what
that
I
can't
really
happen.
Liked is the Flash Restoration. He signs the card, it's torn, they see the signature, and he just goes and waves, and it's instantly unfolded and restored.
And they can do you can do that in their hands.
You can do
as
it
well.
In their hands.
So you've got a torn up card, you tap it, and it restores.
Yes, that is
the trick.
Yeah,
that's the trick.
That's the trick. He's also got a nice one where the business card vanishes from out. You hated that, didn't you?
Didn't
I?
Like
I thought that.
That
was pretty good.
The thing with the bill as well going around the...
But here's the thing that I will say. People are saying what's better is Tool better, is Redemption
Torn
better.
Torn and Restored card, brilliant.
The Torn and Restored card is brilliant, but it is not as versatile as Tool. You cannot do...
And the main reason for that is because you've got to either have a Mercury card folded card...
Or you've got to tear a card
Or
up.
You've got to have a tear a card because you can't vanish a full-size card.
No,
and,
you can't
and
vanish.
And then cleanly show the deck.
No, but what's...
That's the negative.
Exactly. Whilst with Tool, you can. There's so much more you can do with it. Now, the advantage over Tool is you don't have to have a card case in play. With Tool, you do have to have a card.
Yeah, because that's completely, you know, out of the ordinary. The fact you'd have a deck of cards and a card box as well, that's really bad, isn't it?
Some people are finding that an issue with Tool. I'm not, you're not, but some people are going on the Magic Cafe
well,
and going,
the cards
I
out
don't
the
like
box.
The fact that you have to
you
have a card
You leave the box there and it's in play. It's natural.
I know, but at least with Redemption, you don't have to worry about the box at all. It's just
You don't have
the
to
de-
worry. When was the last time you took a cards out of a put the box down. I'm really going to worry about that now. That's a terrible thing that's there. The fact is, I might have to even pick that box up and use it again to put the cards away. That'd be terrible.
I get your point, but some people do have
an
issue with
it. It's a natural object. It is
Look,
a natural
you've
object.
Got to say that the actual... Redemption is good. Redemption's nice. It's only one gimmick that you add to a deck, and when it's in there, you're ready to do this routine. You can ditch the gimmick. You're left with a regular deck of cards. I know you prefer Tool. In all honesty,
Redemption's good for just the Torn and Restored card.
Yeah.
Everything else... I didn't get excited about the applications. I didn't get excited about it. I do think it's a very clever idea. There's lots of ideas on the DVD.
You know, we always say on the show that people rush things to market and, you know, they've had one brain fart and they've decided to make a DVD about it. You can tell with Redemption that he hasn't done that. You can tell with the amount of routines. He cares about the product. He's worked the product.
It's a good product.
Yeah, it is a good product.
For me... It's not as good as Tool.
I've got to agree, I prefer Tool, but I know a lot of people prefer Redemption. And you've got to agree with this statement. David Stone does a Torn and Restored card on the Tool DVD.
Yep.
Comparing Torn and Restored card to Torn and Restored card, the Torn and Restored card you can do with Redemption is better.
It's better.
Because that's what it's designed to do.
But a versatile utility device, which is what they both are,
yeah.
I go for Tool.
Me too. If you've got a certain amount of cash to spend and you can only buy Redemption and you can only buy Tool, if you're looking for a torn and restored card,
do you know
go
what?
For Redemption.
You can even have Tool and have your Redemption inside
well,
set up on the deck.
You could do both.
So you could do both. You could do a whole thing, a whole act just with a card
and
box.
Chris Ballinger is a really nice guy.
He is a very nice guy.
He can't dance. We kicked his ass in the dance competition.
Kick his ass. That's official now.
But... he's a nice guy, but I agree. So there's the fine. In my mind, if you're looking for a torn and restored card, get Redemption.
In the spectator's hands. Brilliant.
If you're looking for a utility device that does a whole bunch more than that, get Tool. If you've got the money, get both. I would give this... if we gave Tool about 90-odd percent, I can't remember exactly, I think it was
still
worth
good.
For the week. Yeah,
I would
give this 84%. I think it's a very good...
Yeah, I was going to say 85%.
Yeah.
That's fair enough.
Yeah, it's fair. It's very
I do
good.
Like it,
but
just not as versatile.
But the argument...
as Tool.
Yeah, Tool's better. Well done, Chris.
You just said Tool was better, though.
And it is better.
Tool's you can't
better.
Say well done, Chris.
Well, no, it's still well done.
Well done for coming second, Chris.
Well done. Second, you know, it's a competition and you can't always be a winner. Chris isn't a winner, but, you know, shut up.
Take six. Right, The Light by Chris Congreve.
Yeah, and full 52 productions.
Kind of a basic card plot, isn't
it's
it?
A side card. It's a version of the Kennedy box or the Destination box or the kiss of the of the, what was
Big
it?
Big Apple.
That him. Yeah, Jamie and Swiss's Big Apple kiss. It's a version of all of these, and the idea is that you have a signed card. It gets
found in an impossible location.
Found in an impossible location, and the nice thing about The Light is that you don't have to just do it with a card. You can do it with a bill. You can do it with a card
other objects
or a bill.
Hang on.
A signed card, a bill, a business card, a billet that's discovered within the inner chamber of a petrol lighter that's been in full view throughout the whole routine.
Wow.
There we go. And there's several routines. Chris is accompanied on the DVD by the one and only living legend Ian Moran, and he puts one of his routines on there.
That's very interesting. Can you do it?
I'd rather not.
Come on, I think
do
you
I
need to.
I only opened it half an hour ago.
I'm not
ago.
Doing that intro again.
Okay. I only opened it half an hour ago, and I'm really not too sure whether I can do it or
you
not.
You can do it.
I can do it. Do you think I can do it without flashing?
Can you get it off the sticks,
yeah.
Jim?
Yeah, Jim, can you get it off the stick? Yeah, we've got Jim behind the camera today.
Jim behind the camera. John's off. Well, apparently he's got things to do with children and that
yeah,
kind
he's
of
just,
thing.
Just had another baby. Congratulations, John.
How does he get time for all this?
I don't know.
Right, okay.
I heard he was actually checking the World Magic Shop website while the kid was being born. Just a rumour.
That is true.
He's like, oh, look, another order. Hey, it's a girl. Anyway, with that in mind.
You know it's true.
It is.
Oh, can I say hello to Jackson as well from the Big Brother team? I promise I'd say hello to Jackson.
And can I say hello to Adam and Nathan?
That's enough.
I thought we were saying hello to random people. And hey, Bob, how's it going? Give the cards a shuffle.
Not funny anymore. Right.
Very good.
Okay.
And
is that good enough?
Yeah, that was really cool. And okay. I want to take a card. I'm going to spread them out so you can see them because, for the sake of this, I want you to pick a card with a lot of white space because you're going to sign it a little better on the camera.
A bit of white space.
Fantastic.
How's that?
And show the card to the camera. Don't show it to me. And show it to the rest of the mob. Now, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to give you a pen.
My Jeff Price impression there. We don't.
We love you, Jeff. We love you, Jeff. What we want to do is take the pen, and you're going to write your name on the front of the card.
Okay.
Big letters. And once again, show it to the camera.
Showing it to the camera.
Fantastic. And you're going to put the card back. Just say stop.
Stop.
Lovely. Put the card there. There we go. I'll put these back on top.
Yeah,
so
that's
you got
great.
The card about halfway down, something like that. I don't know.
You nearly dropped them there for some reason.
I don't know. It's not that I'm nervous or anything like that. Look, what I want you to do is you shuffle the cards for me, Dave.
Would it be good if the Jim came on me with a really tight close-up
yeah,
shot?
Yeah, definitely.
Right, I think that'd
because,
be good.
Because
it's always interesting, isn't it, to look really closely at some cards being shuffled.
Yeah, it's very, very important to do that. I think it's very, very important.
Okay, I think we're done there, Jim, and we can bring it back to a wide shot. There we go. That was very interesting, that shuffling, wasn't it?
By the way, I should point out there's been a lighter there from the very beginning.
Oh my goodness!
It wasn't there from the very beginning.
Shouldn't you have mentioned
it's just
that? Replayed.
No, I just put it down there, but I haven't loaded it or anything yet.
Why don't you do all the shiner patter now?
Yeah, I'm gonna. No, I'm gonna do a.
What you should say at the start is that people use shiners and that kind of thing. They can see the reflection of cards, and just so you draw attention to that lighter.
Anyway, this is my version of card at any number.
Right.
Yeah. You've shuffled your card in
do
the
pack.
Do
you really need to do all that now?
Give me any number between 1 and 52.
48?
Oh, come on, it'll be here forever.
Seven.
Right, deal down to the seventh card.
I know it's not there. Was that you calmed it out. Right, okay. Yeah.
Look, there's been lights there the whole time.
Right.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Hang on a minute. Right, okay, you see there's been a lighter here from the very, very beginning, and if
tight
I open
shop,
it
Jim.
Up... Tight shop,
anything in your hands, Craig?
Nothing in my hands, absolutely nothing. You keep giving me direction, Dave, because I don't know what I'm doing. Nothing in my hands, I'm just going to pull this out like this.
Oh,
and you'll
my
see,
God.
You'll see that there's a folded up card right there in the wallet, in the envelope, cup your hands together for me. There you go, cup your hands together for me. I'm just going to take it and shake it out. And look, you can actually see it's there, shook out of the lighter.
Shooken.
Out of the lighter, but look at this. It's not just any card, Dave, but it is indeed your signed
card.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. It's a miracle.
And I literally opened that up 10 minutes ago.
And said, I can do it flawlessly.
Apparently not. But no, you meant to put the lighter out at the beginning. That's kind of a big important
point.
Yeah,
make sure that it's there.
The key is, it's not loaded, is it?
Is it 52 lighters?
No.
Right, okay.
No, it's not. But the lighter is, this is the thing. The lighter's there from the very beginning. All I have to do is put this back in here. It's now reset, ready to go again.
Right.
Okay. And
a lot of joking aside, this is brilliant. Isn't
this
it?
Is very, very, very good indeed. I think this is so organic.
We didn't stuff that up on the camera because we have played around with this.
Yeah,
for
and this
10
is
minutes,
this is very good, and we weren't messing about. Here's something that Dave actually said while watching the DVD. You actually said this, and you've seen Chris Congreve perform on a few DVDs, and you said this is the best performance you've ever seen Chris do.
Yeah, and it's brilliant. It's
yeah,
a great
it really
trick.
Is great. And you what was
he
that
doesn't
thing
like
you were
an ambitious. Like, routine.
You were talking about Twilight.
Well, I use Twilight Angels, and I have to carry one of these lighters all the time just to do Twilight Angels.
Yeah.
And I don't use it for anything but Twilight Angel. I never even light the thing. So the fact you can have a lighter on there now, do Twilight Angels, give that card away, and then put the lighter down.
Yeah.
Go into an ambitious card and end up with it in the lighter. I find that very exciting.
Yeah, exactly. And Chris's routine that he does on the way to doing the finale, he does an ambitious card routine with Pocket to Pocket sequence by Gary Jones. It's excellent. There's seven or eight other routines. Ian Moran's got a thing with a bill on
we
there.
We jazzed around with it as well, but there's loads of different ways to accomplish the end move.
Yeah.
Essentially, it works the same as a mystery box.
You don't need, don't expect something
really
clever.
But you haven't
really
got a little
clever.
Wooden box.
It does what it says it's going to do. If you want a card or a bill or something else to appear in a very organic object, not a little wooden box that looks like nothing on God's green earth, this is the way to do it. I think this is great. I mean, I have
will only... it fool laymen?
Yes.
100%.
Yeah. Will it fool magicians? No.
No, magicians probably won't get excited about it. Do that for laymen, I reckon they'll be talking about it for weeks.
I think they will. I think this is a very strong...
You can have them holding the lighter.
Yeah. And he's got that really nice gag at the beginning. That
Yeah, what's heavier or lighter? No, that one's the lighter. He's worked it.
You can tell he's worked it.
It is Worker of the Week.
And you know what?
This Worker of the Week.
It's Worker of the Week. And not only is it Worker of the Week, I think it would make a great ending for Chop. I think that when you do Chop, and a few people have actually
it's
told me
it's all got
to
be about him, hasn't it? All the time.
Stuff Chris Congreve.
All the time.
Stuff Chris Congreve. It's all about my stuff. It's
What's
all
that
about there? Chop. Well, oh, don't show that picture, Jim. Don't show that picture.
Worker of the Week board or
something. Yeah, the Worker of the Week board. Somebody sent it in for us, and it's got a picture of me looking like the Pillsbury Doughboy.
Oh, right, that's a bit old, that
and
picture,
it looks,
isn't
and
it?
And it looks like a picture.
All right, then.
Anyway, so
what's
here we
the
go.
Percentage?
Worker of the Week, without a doubt, Christopher Congreve's. This is one of the most commercial things I've actually seen released this year. I'm going to start working it. I'm going to actually work it and
can I
and
just
do
say,
91%? 93%.
There we
worker
go.
Worker of the Week.
We got it out eventually.
Eventually. Well done, Chris.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Right, next up is Big Blind Media presents Ali. Ali, what's that word there? I've never even.
Nurias.
Ali Nurias's Wormhole. Is that his name?
Nurias.
Ali Nurias. I didn't even know it was.
Well, you know what? On the DVD, it looked like Liam Mortimer.
That's what I just assumed.
Yeah, so
just
looked like.
Bang the DVD in, and I thought it was Liam's trick, but it's not. It's Ali's trick.
Ali. His name's Ali.
He's Ali. And it's called Wormhole.
And Big Blind Media, you know, a fantastic production company. You know, generally, as a rule, they bring out some of the best products in magic. Generally, as a rule, normally.
This is good. I know you didn't get excited about it, but this is all right. What this is basically, and
is
this is quite
rubbish.
Popular. If you watched our review from Vegas, you see this whole thing about having a card chosen and very cleanly you can show your hands empty now. This is like a whole buzz thing going on in the magic world that you can then produce it from your own pocket. And that sort of thing without palming. Everybody's getting into this now. You've got Mike Lamar, Jeff Kaler, Chris Ballinger's working on it.
Yeah.
This whole, I've got nothing in my hands, but here it is in my pocket or in a spectator's wallet or whatever.
Okay,
it's very
you're
popular.
You done? Can I have my go?
Right, yeah,
look,
go on.
A single trick DVD, Wormhole, which is being bought out specifically for the one effect and one effect only, which is having a signed card appear in your pocket, right? That's exactly what this
How
is.
How good's
now,
that?
There's three or four different routines, but the general idea is a signed card goes into the spectator's pocket. Now, you can do this with one simple move. Learn to palm a card.
Yeah.
You can do it. You don't need a gimmick. You don't need to carry things around with you. With one single move, you can have a card appear.
And anybody accomplished can do that, can't they?
Anybody can do that.
So why did you insist that Jim did a close-up on me while you did it?
Shut up, Dave! Because...
Yes!
Just because I wanted to, okay? No, seriously. That was that, and this is this. I don't have an answer to that. No, no. Because when you're performing in the real world, you're not performing to a camera.
End of argument.
No, it's not. No.
Anybody can do it. Anybody can do it.
I refuse.
Jim, when we filmed that trick, would you mind just getting a close-up on Dave's hands while I just do a very simple sleight that anybody can do?
Yeah, exactly, because, you know, we're trying to protect the... We're trying to protect the inventor's creation. We don't want to, like, make people realise how it's done by my cack-handed handling. But forget about that. This, you can do it. You can do it with one move, a palm. Now, with a little bit of audience management and routining, you can have a card appear in your pocket without needing to show your hand empty. Let's go back to the light. No, let's go back to the light. Chris Congreve does on there.
He's trying to pull it back, isn't it? But he's already lost.
No, I haven't. No, bear with me. You see, Chris Congreve does on the light DVD, he does a pocket-to-pocket sequence, and he has the card coming out of here and here and here and here. And he doesn't, at no point, does he need to show his hand, because the routining behind it, he can show his hand empty every single time. With this, you've got to carry a gimmick round with you, the deck has to have a gimmick in it,
but
to achieve one single thing.
Let's just be calm about this. The selling point is that you can be totally clean. You've got to admit, at that moment where you're doing your sleight of hand version, let's say, you're dirty. This happens in a moment of relaxation, and that's what you're selling here. The fact that you can just say to them, you know, hold your hand out, and as you say, hold your hand out, what's happened is the same as in palming or whatever, doing this sleight of hand. It happens in a moment of relaxation. And that means then, even though you've only had a moment of relaxation, they've got the deck, they're then shuffling them, you can then show your hands cleanly, and then you can reach into your pocket. Even me, that can do the sleight of hand version, might be tempted into using this methodology.
Let me ask you a question. I know you do card to pocket.
Yeah.
And I know you do it in the real world when you go out and doing paid gigs, and I know you use a palm.
Yeah.
Are you going to tell me that at your next gig you go and do, you're not going to do the palm card version, you're going to take out Wormhole, you're going to shove it in your deck, and you're going to do that instead?
No, because I've been doing those routines for years. But let's say I was doing a one-off thing, and say it was being filmed.
Right.
Right, and I wanted it as clean as it possibly
could be. So you're saying that if something's filmed, it should be as clean as possible. That might be using a gimmick, that might be moving the camera to a different place while the move's done.
It might be,
okay, just clarifying that.
But I like to be a bit fairer with my audience and not as deceitful.
I didn't have a gimmick in the light to be able to do that.
Well, back I know, on track. Right, okay.
Back on track.
Am I going to use it? Probably not. No. But do I think it's clever? I think it's quite clever.
Look, I think that it's things like this that are brought out that stop people that are getting into magic learning how to do magic properly. When I got into magic, it was all books.
It is cleaner.
You read a book and you learned how to do a move and then you went out and you did it.
You're getting all this angry stuff. Tell me honestly, when you watched it, and he had the moment of relaxation, and then you knew he was completely clean.
Yeah.
You went, that's clever. That's good.
Yeah, it's clever. It's clever.
What's changed since then? Now you're just getting all upset about palming. Well, and
you know, there are a lot of selling points. It says it on the back. No moves, no palming, no forces, special gimmicks do the work. So it's hand shown empty at all times, regular deck, resets instantly, no duplicate cards, gimmickly.
In a moment of pure relaxation that wouldn't be picked up by anybody, the cards are then inside your pocket.
Yeah, come on. When you saw Liam do the performance in the middle of the field, randomly, he was walking through a field and he just met two people. And he was like, when you saw Liam do it and he reached into his back pockets and he showed his hands empty and reached into his back pockets, you knew exactly what was going on. And I remember you going, you were like, oh, you know, because you knew.
Well, I knew
you
what was going on.
You can't reach your hand into the pocket and cleanly pull the card out. You got to put your hand behind your back and go, hey, here's the cards. They never see you put your hand into the pocket. At least
what you could do, what you could do is show your hands back and forth like this. You could show your hands and you could just go into your pocket. Anyway, we've said enough. Look,
Big Blind Mean Real Great.
I think it's all right. It's all right.
Okay, let me sum this up for you. I think that if you're a beginner, this is a good thing to do. I think if you're a beginner.
If you're a beginner. Yeah, or you want a super clean version.
But I don't think anybody experienced would do this.
Okay.
Maybe. I'm going to give this 60%.
I think it's worth a bit more than that. I'm going to give it 71.
71?
Yeah.
Okay. 60% from me, 71 from you.
Yeah. Well, we've had Worker of the Week this week,
which was the
light. But a lot of people asked us, right, you guys, you looked around the convention, and we had a lot of people that came up to us at Magic Live and said, what's the best thing you've seen here in
what
the dealer hall?
What is the best thing? Yeah, and there's so much really good stuff.
There was a lot of good stuff.
I thought the appearing helicopter by Mike Michaels
that was good. You wanted to buy one of those for your kid show, didn't you?
For my kid show, make a helicopter up here. I thought that would be really good.
And that big scorpion thing you had.
I like the magic backdrops as well.
Yeah, you actually bought one of those.
I did.
Didn't
I bought
you?
A big theatre
shelled
backdrop.
Out. I want one of those now.
I know, they're so cool. You want to borrow it for lads, don't you?
Yeah, I know. Magicbackdrops.com. They've got some excellent stuff.
Really good stuff.
But we saw Craig Filicetti's Finders Keepers, which was very good.
Great. I mean, you can't. Wow. Yeah, he came and he showed it to us. And
one thing I wasn't clear on with that, which only when I saw it I realised, I thought it was just the key.
Yeah, but it's actually the key fob as well.
The key fob as well, which I think wasn't clear when I read all the ad copy.
No, I thought it was just a key and you added your own key fob. That's a consideration, but it is very, very strong.
And he did it on you, and he was like 50 foot away.
Yeah,
he
went all the way back, and you know, the range that you've got on that is really good.
He knew which hand you had it in. He read your body language at such a long
actually,
distance.
Talking about reading body language, I also like the Know It All Wallet by Mark Mason.
Yeah, well, Mark was on last week's show.
Yeah, yeah, and that was
that'll be available worldwide soon. Yeah, but people asked us
the trick of the convention.
What was the trick? What was the thing we bought?
Yeah,
you know, we did buy quite a lot of stuff, didn't
we? We did buy a hell of a lot of stuff.
But what was the best thing we saw? And unanimously,
we both said this.
The best thing we saw at Magic Live was a trick called Industrial Revelation by Jamie Grant. And this is the best thing we saw at the convention.
I'd also like to say that Jamie is one of the nicest people in magic. And Jim's already getting it off the sticks.
He's already there.
To ask him. Jim's already getting off.
Should we do it?
Well, we'll do it and then we'll talk about it. Can you do it?
Should we do it? Right, okay.
Can I bully you while you are doing it?
You can do that because I can take it because I'm professional. The other day, Craig, I was at a gig and I asked somebody to cut the cards with my colour-changing penknife, funnily enough. And look what they did. They actually cut the cards like that.
Well, who does that?
Isn't that amazing? People before you do this trick.
Oh, right.
They have to cut the cards like that. And this makes an incredible mess of the cards now because, as you can see, all the cards, it's my turn to fumble now, have a little slit through them right now. But this means
that, how you did it?
That I can fold up the card like this, and I can pass that card straight through the center of the card box. Now that, even though you're looking at it with your own eyes, Craig, is absolutely impossible because
no, you've just shown me that all the cards have got holes.
No, you've seen the card go through.
No.
You've seen the knife go through.
Yeah, they've got holes in them.
No, it's impossible.
No, it's
I've
not.
Told you it's impossible because inside the card box is not actually a deck of cards. It's a solid block of steel that weighs exactly 1 ton. And you can check that. Just don't drop it on your toes. Hang on, that's my thing. Don't do that. It's an expensive bit of kit, that is.
So that is the Industrial Revelation.
Get a look at that, Jim. Look how nice that is.
Look at that quality. Look at the quality on that solid block. Now, we've both bought one. We've both got one of these. We both went out and worked it. I've been doing it as an opener at every gig in restaurants, and it has been getting a great reaction. I open with this, and then once I've done this, I then leave it with them, and they're passing it around the table as I do the rest of the act, and then I take it back and put it away.
Hitting their kids with it,
yeah,
sort of
hitting
thing.
Their kids with it. And you know, there's people, it's up to almost 30 pages on the cafe. It's just insane.
Well, it's brilliant. One thing I like, I didn't do it there, but on a table you can actually put it on top of a champagne glass,
right?
And it looks really nice on top of a champagne glass to go through with the dinner knife.
Yeah,
and they see the knife go into the champagne glass and then you pick it up.
It's
and
excellent.
It kind of stages it in a lot nicer way, and people like gather around. They love it. They love looking at it.
They have no idea how it works. It's such a strong moment of astonishment, as Paul Harris would say. It really is.
I like that. I don't know if anybody else has come up with this idea. You read the CAF more than I have, but I came up with this idea of actually taking one card out that's got the slit in it.
Right.
So they convince themselves even more that the whole deck is just that way with a slit in. Then using that card to go through. And then just revealing that solid block.
It's so strong. And Jamie, this is the care and attention that he puts into these. The packaging comes with a little coin on the outside, a little antique coin.
Because he passes a coin through, doesn't
he? He passes a coin through, and I asked him why he did that, and he said because he wanted everybody to have everything they need in order to perform the effect. So he actually gives you a coin so you can do it immediately.
So they could do it straight away.
He's such a nice guy. He gave us personal instruction on this, didn't he?
It is, as he did with everybody. It is brilliant.
Yeah.
It was the worker of Magic Live. It's one of the best things that I've bought in a long time.
I think it's the best thing that I've got in the last couple of years. It's awesome.
Very strong piece of magic. We don't sell it.
You can't get it from us. I mean, if you want a percentage, I'd give it 98% easily.
Yeah, he's right up there.
98%, 99%. You can't get it from World Magic Shops.
You can't get it. You have to go to sendwonder.com.
That's www.sendwonder.com.
But we want it to be fair, because so many people said, what's the best trick?
Yeah, and even though we can't sell it, we want to be completely honest and say this is the best thing that Magic Live, this is the best thing that we've seen for a long time.
We want to say as well that after this video today, we've got another bonus interview from Cos, from Cosmo Magic.
Yeah, and he's got a huge announcement.
A huge announcement. You might want to watch that, especially if you invent magic. You might be quite interested in that. But that's it this week for the Wizard Product Review.
Thanks.
Follow us in all the
watching.
Usual places.
www.themagiccafe.com, www.facebook.com/worldmagicshop, www.youtube.com/worldmagicshop. Check us out on Murphy's Magic Community, and I think that's about it. Find us.
You've run out now.
There's nowhere else.
We'll be back next week, 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. Craig's off now to practice misdirection whilst palming.
Okay, so next up on the sofa, we have a good friend of mine. it's Cosmo from Cosmo Magic.
Hey
Cos.
What's up,
thanks
man?
For having
good,
me
good,
here.
Good
you
to see
man.
You guys.
You're on the sofa. You're now, last night you were on stage with some of the greatest magicians.
Yeah, seriously.
From like the last few decades.
How does it feel to actually have you on the front cover of Magic Magazine?
Oh man, it's unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah.
You've still got that same shirt from the cover. You were wearing the same shirt as well.
It's a different shirt, but it's very similar, isn't it?
Yeah. Look the same.
I bet you've got about 40 that look virtually the same. Right.
I got a bunch of them, yeah.
So you're here with Real Magic, and obviously Cosmo Magic as well.
You guys are just setting the world on fire with your products.
Oh, thanks.
There's never a bad product that comes out from Cosmo Magic. At least there's not one that I've seen. Every single time, it's a hit and a hit and a hit. And you just brought out the stand-up Monty.
Gary Thomas, that Garrett showed us on the show.
A lot of buzz about that effect after Blackpool Convention, when Garrett actually did it on the sofa at the Blackpool Convention. We get emails every week saying, do you know when that's actually coming out? Can you guys find out for us? So it's actually launched at this convention, yeah?
Yeah, this is it. We only brought 100 pieces. I think it'll be sold out in the next hour or two. Yeah. This thing is fantastic.
We went by the stand yesterday, and Garrett just did it once, and I think like 12 people bought it straight away. Yeah. It was crazy.
We were at a convention. This thing is so good. We had a convention a few months ago, the IBM convention or something, and Gary and I are having lunch, and Jeff McBride came up and walked up and just started talking about this track. Greatest Monty effect ever. I mean, this is a classic.
Jeff McBride. That's not a bad quote, as quotes go.
Ever.
You know, it's not bad.
You know, this is really killer. I mean, this is a worker. There's no question.
But the thing that you're most excited about is Real Magic Magazine, isn't it?
I love Real Magic Magazine. Yeah. Are you guys getting it? It should be.
Yeah. I mean, it's been going out for about 5 years now.
Yeah. Episode 24 is coming up.
And amazing. Yeah. You advertise it as TV for magicians.
Right. Yeah. You've
it's
seen
awesome.
It.
I've seen it.
You're in it.
I've been in it. Yeah.
You're gonna be. You were in it.
Yeah.
We're gonna be in it. We're proud to be in it. Yeah. We can't believe we're gonna be in it.
I can't believe we're so excited to have you.
So the Monty. Anything else coming up from Cosmo Magic?
I heard that you had a big announcement.
Hey,
listen, man.
You can't make a statement like that on the Wizard product review and back that.
Yeah,
you've got
to
back that up.
It's gonna be going out for the first time right here.
All right. So this is the announcement. The greatest magic trick ever invented, in my mind, is Low Sanders' floating table.
Yeah, very good trick.
Looks very good.
Don't you think?
It looks very good.
I mean, it looks like real magic to me.
Yeah, it's awesome.
So, Low Sander and I were talking about this and saying, well, you know, what's the next great magic trick? What's the next one?
Okay.
The next one? Well, we don't know. But somebody out there, of the 25,000 people that watch this, probably have something that's great.
Yeah.
If you have something that's great, send me a video of it. Low Sander will pick the winner, and the winner's going to get $5,000. We hope. Wait a minute.
I've actually got a new trick.
Yeah, Coinbase 3, right?
Yeah, Coinbase 3. Yeah. I think just became available.
And I've got this thing called Chop 2.0.
We'll throw that in.
$5,000.
What's the catch, right? They'd have to sign all the rights over to you.
No. All we want to do is see it. We don't even need to know how it's done. We just want to see a great trick.
Hang on. Back up the truck.
Hang on. Right?
So you're saying
put it on video.
If somebody's got a trick that they think's really good, they put it on video, they send it to you. You and Lysander look through them.
Is there a website they upload the videos to, or links to YouTube channel?
Just shoot me an email and we'll figure out how to get the video to us.
And the winner's going to get $5,000.
You know what? I think that the world's next great magic trick, just for me to be able to see it, is worth more than $5,000. Let's pop it up to $7,500 right now.
What?
The winner gets $7,500. $7,500, the biggest cash prize in magic at Real Magic Magazine. Send me an email at cosmomagic@me.com. And
you don't even need to reveal it. You just need to do it. But no video effects, right? It's got to be a genuine effect.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to have to tell me how it's done so I know it's real. But I retain no rights to it.
No rights?
We just want to be able to show people in the magazine.
You could get the award if you wanted to, and then you could bring it out with whoever you wanted to.
Exactly right.
That's just amazing.
That's unbelievable.
Are you feeling okay?
I think $7,500, that might not be enough money.
Yeah, you've been walking around in the sun.
Let's make it $8,500.
No, hang on. $85. Let's make it $10,000.
$10,000. The next greatest magic trick. You send it to me, cosmomagic@me.com. Just show it to me.
You know, we need to win.
Be a winner.
Before he gives away all his money. He's up to 10 grand already.
This is serious. So, what's the address again?
Cosmo Magic, K-O-Z-M-O, magic@me.com, me.com. Can you guys put a little?
Put it up.
Yeah, it's not like it's real magic. It's the Wizard product review. We can probably
Put it up. I might just keep it. I might just actually delete this interview right now and save that for myself. That's unbelievable.
Okay, so you heard it here first. $10,000.
Send me your trick.
Send him a trick. And if you haven't done it already,
can we help judge
subscribe?
Can we help judge it?
You guys want to get involved?
Yeah, we want to help judge it.
Let's get these guys involved.
We see more magic than anybody. Come on.
There we go, baby. Here we go.
We're going to judge it. $10,000.
Four judges. Cool?
Send in your entries.
Thanks.